The pandemic caused by the virus SARS-CoV-2 has affected each and every one of us and changed the way we live our day-to-day lives. In the US, we cannot ignore the increasing amount of data showing that marginalized groups have been disproportionately affected by COVID-19. And today we want to highlight one of these disparities in the amount of deaths associated with the virus. Now, Black and Hispanic Americans represent around 30% of the total US population, but these same groups account for over 70% of all deaths associated with COVID-19. And these numbers are not just skewed towards the elderly. If we break down the numbers for people aged 35 to 54 in these marginalized groups, we see that they have up to an 11 times more likely chance of dying from COVID-19 than individuals in non-marginalized groups. These are young parents being killed by the virus, leaving their children as orphans and creating generational damage that will take decades to overcome. And while each death associated with COVID-19 will have its own circumstance, we wanted to break down some of the social determinants to make you more aware. Now, the first is occupation, as individuals in marginalized groups are more likely to be essential workers. This can be working in a factory or in the pipeline of getting food from farm to your table, putting them at higher risk of community spread. Next is living situation, as it's customary in different cultures for multiple generations to live in the same household. This can create extreme difficulties if someone needs to quarantine away from their other family members. And last is health status, as prior research has shown that for a variety of different reasons, individuals in marginalized groups are more susceptible to diabetes or heart disease, which are comorbidities associated with COVID-19. And some steps we can begin to take to advocate for these social determinants are provide proper PPE for essential workers, such as N95 masks. Second is to provide vaccines to these essential workers, regardless or not of their immigration status. And this is not the first pandemic where marginalized groups have been disproportionately affected. But if we want to return back to work, send our kids back to school, or even go to a bar, we need to take into account these social determinants to create better public health measures related to race and ethnicity to stop the spread of this virus.